Let's do it a little maintenance. Hold on.
Thank you.
of a little fanny pack. I'm sure as you keep using it, you'll get used to more and more blender things. You'll do more intricate stuff, and you could model all the silly novelty fanny packs you want. I want the antenna of it. Get it. Okay. Move all this down a little bit. too many. I have too many. It'd be great if I could get myself to work on these, you know, during the day when I'm not streaming. But the reason I started doing this in the first place is because I have trouble making myself focus on stuff, so... So it's hard for me to work on things any other time, which is why it's taken me so long to do these. Today I was gonna work on them, but then I ended up working on the pond for like a few hours. And I hurt my back. I just want some nice updated refs for my characters. If I have to, I'll just upload these and continue working on the other ones and upload those throughout the event. I have a hard time making my brain cooperate. At least I'm getting some stuff done on the pond that I wanted to do. Because currently it's losing water every time I run the pump, which is not helpful. So I'm trying to move where the water comes back out to a better place, and also sort of seal it up a little so it doesn't splash water where it's not supposed to splash water, and hopefully that'll save water. Thank you. tart. Oh yeah, this is Media's favorite accessory. It's a glittery, like it's not colored in yet, but when it's colored in, it's gonna be glittery pink. And it says bitch embroidered across the front in cursive letters and has an extra long scrap because he is rather chunky. I am very tired, my back kinda hurts, and I pull the muscle on my bicep, but what else is new? Yeah, I was trying to move some big rocks because I have a little pond in the backyard that Wait, I need more ice, do you want? my dad wanted to make a pond years ago and then of course stopped halfway through the project because why wouldn't he? So I decided, last year, the year before, I can't remember when it was. No, like a couple years ago, I decided that I was going to take over the pond and revive it and make it my pond because it was just kind of collecting stagnant water and becoming a mosquito pit and it was just really not okay. So, I revived it and this year I'm trying to figure out how to stop the problem it has with losing water. If I run the pump for too long. And the pump kind of needs to be running to benefit the fish and the plants. So I was moving a bunch of rocks around because I need to move the hose that's buried under all the rocks that puts the water from the pump to the other side of the pond. And lifting all the heavy rocks was not great for my arm. It is my drawing arm, but thankfully it's up in the bicep, and I do not follow the advice you're supposed to do, where you're supposed to draw with your whole arm, because I usually draw small things, so it's not bugging me too much, it's just whenever I have to move my whole arm. Other eyes is blind, right? Wait, yeah. Earlier today I was doing the irrigation for the stupid lawn and I accidentally let the water flood a little bit too far into the yard and so I had to bail out part of it with a little bucket. I saved as much of the water as I could to use for watering my garden, so it's not completely gonna go to waste, but a bunch of arm and back action today. I'm gonna be so sore tomorrow. And for some reason I decided to move around a bunch of furniture. I don't know, I just... One of them days where I don't know how to calm down. Maybe tomorrow my arms will hurt so much after failing to heal properly like they usually do because of my condition that I won't be able to do anything but sit down and draw, and then I'll have to draw these off stream. Or I I could slump over and play ESO all day. I mean, you know, that might happen too. Had a better day. That's a good feeling. I haven't drawn this character in so long that I can't remember what his facial hair looks like. I used to draw him so much. That's one of those OCs I actually used. Any original character is an original character if you just draw them, and then anything you draw even once can be original design if you thought of it, but like, there are those ones that actually become characters instead of just character concepts or designs that you actually use a lot. Like, draw multiple times and make comics with and stuff. Thank you. I did not know that already existed, but I'm glad that it does. Also, I can't think of the name Chihiro without thinking it's a Spirited Away character. You have an Elmo? Okay, so one of your characters is literally Elmo from Sesame Street. Wonderful. Imagining some, like, I can't remember what all these characters are, but some, like, classic smexy anime boys in, like, wizard hats, but one of them is just Elmo with anime eyes. Yes, like Elmo from Sesame Street. No matter what, I'm gonna think Elmo from Sesame Street. Someone's definitely had to have drawn anime Elmo by now. Someone's gotta have drawn anime every character from Sesame Street. I've probably seen it on Tumblr. It feels familiar, like I should have seen it before. Maybe to stop people from associating your character with the Sesame Street character, you'll have to name him Saint Elmo. Although people who aren't familiar with the fire would probably be picturing, like, Elmo in a Pope hat or something. Still, though, I mean, that's pretty funny. Thank you. snake cake. Sometimes you just gotta flatter your friends. I remember back in the day when, like, texting and stuff wasn't advanced as it is today, or any messaging on a phone. And a horrible prank that some of my friends liked to play on either each other or people they just didn't like was sending someone a message via text word by word back when texting rates were by the text. And they had to pay to receive it. Then they'd have to text back like, please stop this, my parents are gonna get so pissed off about the bill. I don't think my friends did it much, but definitely enjoyed their little joke. I don't know. Do you have enough colors? I don't watch a ton of Magical Girl stuff, but usually they they all have a color, so they fill out like a color set. Even in Madoka, it was like CMYK. The color sets of the main characters. And also pink, but she was a bit of an exception. Pink is always a leader. So if you have a pink one, they're the leader. Have to do that, but
thank you. Make a smile.
gonna freeze to death. Oh, let me hop in my car and bring you my laptop, which is currently very warm. It'll only take me like 13 hours or something. Yeah, I know. If I can make myself work on these outside of stream, well, I would have already gotten them done, but I started coloring some of these a while ago. So a few of them have colors. She looks so fucked up with all the lines there. I'd like to put a couple extra things in some of these just for fun, you know? Like little details of their outfits, but... Okay, and then I stopped at Capra. If I drive really fast, I can make it 13. I can do it. I will speed. Don't underestimate me. Yeah, if I can just, if I can make myself fucking focus on these outside of streaming time, I'll be able to get them all done. I'm not even trying to do them only in streaming time. I've tried to do them, like, on my own time before, and that thing happens where it just doesn't happen. It just don't start. I could just do more art streams, like, during the day, but... I swear, I could look at the same ref, like, a million times over and over, and still forget what I just looked at. Yeah, last time I went on a little road trip by myself, I was determined to get back at a certain time, so I kind of pushed it, didn't even take a rest, half awake, delirious on the road, shouting along to Fall Out Boy at like 4 a.m. But I was holding down on the, isn't my horsey so cute? I was holding down on the accelerator for so long because my car's cruise control doesn't work. It doesn't, like, it does not drive by itself. It doesn't have that. So my quad, my right quad in particular, was fucked up. And my left quad, because sometimes I switch between legs to save my legs some strain, which didn't do much, but... Literally, what did I do? Okay. The panel. I don't even need this to be perfectly accurate. I just want it to look somewhat sort of like the armor she's wearing right now because I think it's really cute. Yeah, my car, like, has the option for... Did I just completely forget that I gave her an eye patch? I completely forgot that I gave her an eye patch. Because I was like, that looks badass in character creation, and then I keep forgetting she has an eye patch. Aren't they cool? It's actually a, like, you know, in Habitica, in Habit RPG, whatever they call it nowadays, which I still play it, even though you and Kanto signed off. You can choose, like, a costume to go over your armor. They also have that in ESO. Where you can have the armor you're actually wearing and then the costume that goes on top of it. I don't even know what my armor currently looks like. I should probably check it out someday. Yeah, I was like, I like the idea of wearing quilt pants. I'm into that. Especially since at the time I was doing a bunch of quests in Skyrim, which is very cold. There we go, now she's got her eye patch. Just completely forgot to give my character a goddamn eye patch. That's my chonky horse, which I never ride. I can't remember the button to call the horse. There's a pointy backward ear. I wish I saw that represented more in, like, 50s fashion. Oh, hell yeah. In 50s stuff, you only ever see, like, the cutesy cocktail dresses that, like, 80% of the things on Chicstar are inspired by. Hell yeah, you can make it all black with, like, bright purple stitching. And as a lining, you could put in, like, skeleton print fleece or something. Literally, what did I just look at? Okay. A little more of a chest than that. Torso needs to be a little bit longer. Oh no, I drew another character too tall. I made her the tallest height I possibly could. And then in the game, because of the version I was gifted, thank you, Tarp, came with all the recent DLC, like all the DLCs up to the one at the time, which was Greymoor, which is this, like, the Skyrim DLC. So it was like, cool, familiar territory back in good old Skyrim. Oh yeah, I met one of the characters for the Skyrim, like, story quest is Lyris Titanborn. And the moment I saw her, I was like, can we marry NPCs in this game like you could in Skyrim? Because she makes my tallest height setting orc look like a fucking little teenager in comparison. She's beautiful. I love Lyris Titanborn. She's also really cool. She's a half giant. Golf NES. Unless you're saying Golf NES, which I sometimes accidentally say Gillaby's other nickname. Ah! Hey, DC. Thankfully, the internet should be more solid than the last time you were part of a raid that tried to come here. I had to do some computer maintenance stuff and fix some stuff, and it seems to be okay now. Her arms look like she's wearing that. Hey. Yeah, they do other things. Switching back and forth between the dark screenshot and the, like, the light background of this is, hurting my eyes. I'm so sorry if it's hurting anyone else's eyes. Oh yeah, I couldn't donate much, but I was like, oh man, I missed the Juneteenth fundraiser, so I'll contribute a little bit. I was like, I can do $5. Not much, but I hope it helps something. Yay. Thank you. You're welcome all. Next to that or something. Wait, why am I drawing a bird when she has a pet torch bug? It's so much better. That's sort of the vibe I was going for, because in the character creation of Elder Scrolls Online, I was like, I want orcs because they have cute little tusks, and I think they're cool. I decided I wanted to make her, like, the burliest, biggest, somewhat, like, intimidating-looking orc possible. But also, she's very sweet and loves animals and nature, and, you know, one of those gentle giant characters I love so very, very much. She has a pet torch bug, which I have named Torchy. Spelled like this, with a IE. I've decided she's not super creative at names. Yeah, in her gruff, gruff voice, she would definitely love singing pretty songs to her pet torch bug, who I got as a gift from Tart, because she already had this pet. Can't remember what the torch bugs look like. They have these little winged bugs with, like, big glowing butts. Wait, how big are their wings? Their wings are always moving, so I don't know. Boop, boop, boop. Yeah, and like all the insects and stuff in Skyrim, it's ESO, the entire Elder Scrolls series, it's a little bit oversized. it's not the actual size of a lightning bug. To be a big lightning bug. Even if I get other pets, I don't know if I'm going to be able to put Georgie away. Maybe if I get other pets, I could let Georgie retire to a house that I will have someday in the game. Because you can get houses. There's an entire section of, like, ESO streamers who just do housing streams where they, like, decorate their houses and build stuff around their houses. And it's, like, really interesting. There'll be people going on quests to get specific items for their houses or completing, scrying for antiquities so they could get special stuff for their houses. And it's, like, people redecorating their new mansions that they bought after, like, playing for 100 hours to get up gold, stuff like that. I don't really want a mansion, but I want a nice house at some point. Maybe I could let Torchy live in the garden. Let Torchy retire from a hard life of adventuring. Does it have, like, different levels? Like, level one, this house is, it's okay, but it could be more snazzy. And then, like, level 10 is, like, you move into, like, a hoarder house that's been abandoned for 30 years. We got this, and also it's, like, extremely haunted. Like, we got this place on a deal. Probably because it's extremely haunted. And also a complete fucking mess. A pair of pajamas with this quilted material. Just make a pair of quilt pajamas. Also, the quilted house jacket sounds great. Like, this house is a bit of a special case. If a door slams, the camera goes around wildly, the cameraman runs out of the building. You hear screams behind you. Then it jump cuts to a completely different host. Like, this house is a bit of a special case. For now, we're staying outside until the priest gets here. Tools Up is a cute name for a fixing game. Oh, cool. I don't know, so you could be a creepy minimalist who probably gets a new iPhone every year. Probably wears nothing but yoga pants and loose shirts. Probably has those glove feet. Oh yeah, goth solar punk. Health goth. I Yeah, usually solarpunk is sort of a very light and airy kind of aesthetic, but what if it just had a darker color scheme? Maybe some bones? Repurposing bones can be a form of recycling. You know, I'd love to have a couch someday, but the new iPhone X10, new iPhone X10 5000 just came out, and well, you know, I gotta get it. What did I do with the other one? I sold it so I could pay for the new one. Yes, I eat nothing but like canned soup, not heated up because I don't even have a microwave, but you know, it's really worth it to be so into the latest technology. Oh wait, they also have an Alexa. That's all they have, an iPhone and an Alexa. And a perfectly spotless, clean White House. Yeah, that sort of really clean Apple Store, quote-unquote, futuristic look. I do not like that type of minimalism, that kind of extreme, stark, bare minimalism where there's, like, nothing there. If you've ever seen one of my tidying streams where I'm cleaning up something in my room, anyone could tell that I am definitely a maximalist. Is there a blank spot on the wall? But put a poster on it. What are you doing? You don't go to sleep on a pile of plushies and pillows. And what are you doing? You don't have like 20 plants in each window. What are you doing? Wait, that hand doesn't make any good sense. Yeah, it's like Apple stores are like if someone tried to make a liminal space on purpose. So it's like, it doesn't even have that natural feeling of like the artificiality of certain liminal spaces. You know, places that have that kind of vibe. It feels manufactured. Limbonal. Yeah, like solar plants. We got the plants. We got the renewable energy. Solar panels on everything. Like, hey, what's up? Do you hate nature? You better. Do you have any plants in your perfect minimalist box house? It better be big. Just there for the aesthetic. Oh yeah, I'm wearing those fuzzy boots right now, okay. Yeah, it was great. It was like, is there a time when they uncage and unshame the vending machines? Because I saw vending machines and I was kind of excited to get some roadside snacks. But, wait, were they still working? So they were just, like, contained? I legit can't remember. Good night! I can't even remember where that was, but I really liked it. Did that go? Yeah, the padding goes all the way up. Yeah, remember since at least a few of them had lights on. Oh yeah, that's why I didn't get anything. The ghosts got there before us. Ate all the snacks. Let the machines free. Maybe they were contained for a reason. Maybe it's for the traveler's own good, who knows. I didn't draw the pants lumps in a way that would entirely make sense, you know, for like the quilting. Right? It had a very eerie vibe, that place. I can't even remember why we were driving back. Was it? Yeah, it's just like an isolated memory that I have of us finding the weird truck stop, like night truck stop, rest stop, and being like, this is weird, right? We're like, yeah, this is something a little eerie about this place. Yeah. It's like a really nice rest stop. With all the vending machines and the, like, the architecture of it, and it had all the tables, and, like, what? If it was Mama's house, that might make sense, but the thing is, I don't, is that on the way to Mama's house? Okay, I can't remember where the rest stop is, which makes it even more of a liminal space. I don't know where the hell it was. Cause like, usually when I come back that way, I don't remember seeing any rest stops, even when I'm coming back from there late at night. I don't know when the next time I'm gonna go there is, after Mema passed away. Rest in peace, Mema. Maybe it was like a one of those times we were going bone hunting with Ro back when she still lived at Meadow Lake, or I can't remember. I feel like we were coming back north after going south. Wait, was it that one time we went to visit that furry friend of yours? So that you two could run around suiting, and so I could be like the handler, and we were playing frisbee and stuff in that one park. Was that it? Cause like, I remember it was a bit of a... Oh yeah, I didn't notice. I hope it was a creepy liminal space moment. It might have been... I'm thinking now that it had to have been that furry friend. And we got accidentally, waylaid because my tire was, like, really low and they had to help give us a tire fill-up. Because, yeah, usually when I'm driving back from, Las Lunas, I don't see that rest stop, but if it was in Berlin... Oh, yeah, it was that golf course we thought it was for. Yeah, it didn't say it was a golf course. I mean, it was just open. It looks like a park. It's got grass and a big field. I mean, like, it was near a bunch of houses. How is that not a park? That's a park. Sounds spooky. Montana sounds like a great place for spooky things to happen. But yeah, they kind of look like Uggs. Okay, there's some high-rise Uggs here. High-rise fur-lined Uggs. Quilted bottom pants, Uggs with the fur. Are they even like blunt-toed? They're pretty blunt-toed. Oh, hell yeah, that's a cool dream. Well, it must have been really scary, but... I'd been pretty freaked out. Right, that doesn't even, like, I was expecting, like, I don't know, saw something spooky in the distance or in the restroom or something. Was not expecting weird dream about eyeball plants. But I'm intrigued. Let me draw the Uggs with the fur. I used up all my fast drawing ability on the previous two characters. I keep accidentally racing twice, come on. Might have been a hypnagogic hallucination. How dare you? Dare you make us all lose the game? Maybe your mom knew the plants personally and was like, oh god, this is embarrassing, I gotta get my kids out of here before I get embarrassed in front of my kids. And so she had to go back and tell the plants, so like, look, we're done, Henry, we're done, I'm not done with you, I'm not worth you anymore, give it up. I have kids, I have a family now. Your dreams are possibly on the same level of weird as Skelebee's. I don't think hers usually feature popular Looney Tunes, though. Those are usually, like, horrible, monstrous abominations. I have very boring dreams, except sometimes for when they're horror dreams. Not even necessarily nightmares, just like horror-themed dreams. I like those ones because they're not boring. Dreams where they're like, original content, do not steal. I think the only, like, Donald Duck of all things. I think the only dreams I've had that featured anything familiar were ones where my friends were in there. Or me, wait. Yeah, ones where my friends in my house were there. On my pets. But, like, the only dreams I have where there's, like, media involved, they're usually, like, ones where I've been playing a video game for way, way too long. And I'll dream about playing the game. Not necessarily that I'm in it, just that I'm playing it. Wait, where do I... Okay, I didn't have one. Okay. That's my little... You know, I gotta get up because I realize I've been sitting on my tailbone kind of weird. I gotta do some stretches. I'm gonna try to keep working on these, although I'm also very tired and I shouldn't stay up too long, so And you know what? I'm gonna hope. I'm going to hope and pray that, Sunny D? What the fuck? Yeah, that's just pretty weird there, dude. Finally, someone for whom cartoon nightmares are representative of their actual nightmares. Detailing the turn of day here. Okay, I lost my fast drawing privileges for the day apparently, but I can still. Why did I give her a fingernail on a gloved hand? All of my fast drawing ability on Median Ilzen, and then I got all my detail drawing ability here. Okay, I gotta sign off in a sec. It is 1:30. Let me see if there's anyone I can raid. You wait. Did you think it was actually a giant anthro mouse? That's way scarier. Should I even bother reading to that now? You know what? I know everyone else has got stuff to do. to continue watching Midsommar. I don't remember you telling me about that one, I don't think, but that's a pretty rad dream right there. That sounds like the kind where people would be like, bruh, that like means something, dude. Okay, I guess like thinking that like, oh, there's a person inside of this costume. That would definitely freak me out. And then you grew up to love full body costumes, so. Did I say this 5 times? Let me make sure I say this at least 5 times in a row. Oh. Don't not say it as. Damn it. Take a break right before I have to figure out how to draw a character from the back again. Okay. Ugh. Still being Mercier, as I will see you too on Discord after I stop hiccuping. Weirdly traumatic childhood experience makes you ugh about Mickey all your life. Me personally, I don't like Peppa Pig. I also don't like any, I hate the show Chowder, and I refuse to look at Phineas and Ferb because the triangle kid, Skelby knows how much I fucking hate the triangle kid. I don't even have a bad experience with it. I just hate his stupid ugly face. It's a triangle. He has big bulbous fucking goldfish eyes sticking out the side of his triangle head. It's disgusting. I have to end the stream before I start talking about bad character design anyway. See you later. Bye.